Oh my God, we're going to jail.
I made brownies with my roommate. What happened was, I had a dream that I did drugs. I woke up and I was like, alright, let's do it. This was a great experience for me because not only did I never touch the plant ever in my life, but I was also sad, miserable, and broken. So I was like, what could go wrong? We made two batches, started munching, and at that time, I was like, maybe I should read up what will happen when we actually take these, even though we already taken them. Let me pull out my phone. I Googled it and Google was like, it hit me like a brick wall. Oh my gosh, I almost died. And I was like, I look over to my roommate and this hoe was popping these brownies in like miniature M&Ms. I was like, sir, are you okay? This man on Google said it hit him like a brick wall. And then roommate is just over here laughing.
A brick wall.
Continues to eat more brownies. I'm like, I literally had to take the pan of brownies away from this fool. Like, I can't have him dying. I need someone to pay the other half of rent. So he ended up eating a total of 6 brownies. I had 3. I only had 3 because I was like, if he dies, I don't want to live either. Like, I can barely afford my side of rent. We're sitting around for almost a complete hour and the brownies have not hit us yet. We feel completely normal. So I suggest we just skate to Walmart and get some McDonald's. As we're skating, there's a car driving by with a mattress on the roof of it. And roommate is like, am I high or does that car have a mattress on it? And I'm just like, we just left the apartment and the brownie has already hit this man's. But I don't even realize it because I don't even know what it feels like to be high. So I'm like, whatever, let's just go get some McDonald's. Like, on the way to McDonald's though, I'm starting to feel it. I feel like I'm actually floating, but at the same time, this electric feeling is flowing through my veins. It's kind of eerie. But we finally make it to Walmart, we make it to McDonald's, and I get my little 10 piece and my french fry, and we go home right away because Mans is over here about to have a panic attack. But I don't even realize Mans is about to have a panic attack. Again, I don't even realize that he's been gone since we left the house. I'm just like, chillax. We make it back home and it still has not hit me, but Rumi is in the corner laughing maniacally at the cabinets, and I'm just like, okay, wow. I start to eat my chicken nuggets and I dip one in sauce. I take a bite, I dip it back in the sauce, and that's it. All of a sudden, I can distinguish every slight sound around me. The ceiling fan, the rattle of the air conditioner, the wind blowing against the apartment outside. And all of these sounds start fusing together in repetition and begin to make a rhythm. And the rhythm slowly gets faster and faster and faster. I start pacing back and forth between rooms, walking between my room, the living room, Rumi's room. And every time I exit and re-enter a new room, it feels like a completely new room. It felt like everything was changing, but still felt like everything was staying the exact same. I would walk into one room and it would feel like winter, then the next room fall, and then the next spring, then it would feel like nighttime, and then it would feel like day, then it was Tuesday, then it was 3:15. I come back gradually from my high, and I see Rumi standing in the kitchen with me. And I'm just like, oh my God, I was actually hi. I'm like, what? And there was a fan, and what? And there was rooms, and what? There was. And he's just high AF, like, yeah, LMAO. And then it hits me again. I'm like, oop, I'm going back. So the thing about emotions when you're on cloud nine, out your mind like this, emotions are really strong. If you're angry, you're really angry. And you remain angry for 5 minutes. If you're happy, you're really happy for 5 minutes. If you're worried, you get the point. It's like your emotions have a lag on them. Your speaking has a lag on it. You can't talk. The only thing that makes any sense are your own thoughts. The first time the edible hit me, it wasn't scary because the first time I had no idea what was going on. I thought I was dreaming. The second time it hit me, I realized that I was stuck in a loop and it was just going to keep hitting me again and again and again. And I also realized that I hadn't even peaked yet. So the second time around, I started to get worried. I started to get scared, but the high made me feel really worried and really scared. Y'all, I called my ex. I was not using my brain. Probably because the weed had it captive. I ain't have a brain anymore. I was just trying to think of anything that would soothe my thoughts and just get me away from the panic attack that I was about to have. And the hallucinations. I was going through my phone and looking through my contacts, and I had contact photos for people. When I checked the next day, I definitely did not have any of these contact photos saved, but I saw like vivid pictures of people as my contacts in my phone. I call, no answer. I left a voicemail. This girl probably thinks I'm a crackhead and blocked my number, which is her right. She's not wrong. I'm over here on the verge of a panic attack. And then I come out of my trip and I'm like, wow. I tried to call that hoe. Hide my phone. Take this. I literally see him physically take my phone and put it behind the pillow. And 5 minutes later, I'm like, where is my phone? I'm tripping. I'm confused, I'm dazed, scared, but I'm trying to use logic and reason because my thoughts are the only thing that make any reason to me. I know I can't actually be scared or it'll get worse. I know I have to accept how confused I feel. Rumi sees me fighting the demons in my head and is just looking at me like, and then I'm just over here like, LMAO, it's okay, let's turn on the TV. I told y'all I'm a crackhead. Like, every demon on my head was fought on site that day at that moment in my head. So me and Rumi were laughing, dancing around, enjoying ourselves. It's a good trip. And all of a sudden, Rumi disappears into the bathroom. So I'm just enjoying my own company. But Rumi didn't close the door. So I can hear him throwing up. All of the worry and fear rushes back to me. He comes out the bathroom. I'm like, yo, WTF? And he's like, oh, I'm fine. Okay, but like, are you really fine? I feel suspicious. Like, oh, he's hiding something, huh? He's not telling me the truth, huh? And I guess he can sense my suspicion of him. So we're both just looking at each other like, huh? Why don't we just have a seat on the couch? And he's like, yeah. Why not? We pull out guns. I mean, they're like imaginary guns, but the weed makes them feel very real. So I decide we should just remain seated on the couch because it's calming our high. Sitting on the couch, it doesn't feel like the room is constantly changing around us and warping. So we just relax. At least I'm trying to relax. I feel like static shock. I feel charges of electricity surging through my veins. After a few minutes, I look over and he's slumped, but I'm scared to fall asleep. For one, when I close my eyes, the trip doesn't stop. It just continues in my head and makes me feel dizzy. And also, when I close my eyes for 2 seconds, I hear demons and my roommate running around the room. And I'm panicking, I'm like, oh my gosh! He's going to throw me out the window. And then as soon as I open my eyes and look back over, he's still asleep. Never moved an inch. I'm paranoid, so I just watch TV. And it's a YouTube Beyonce playlist. Beyonce has seen me through some dark days. I sat there and watched Beyonce for 5 hours. It felt like 5 hours. Watching music videos when you're tripping makes your perception of time terrible. I will watch one video, and that 1 4-minute video would last at least 20 minutes. I was so confused, but intrigued. Like, Beyonce has been singing the same verse at least 7 times in a row. Like, I don't know if she plans on getting to the point, and then there would be 5 Beyoncés on the screen at one time. And I was just like, yeah. Yeah, this is how I want to die. I'm okay with this. I'm like a few hours into it and I'm actually starting to accept the trip. I'm getting into the vibe of it. Like, I got a whole routine down now. I would trip, and then once my brain came down for like 45 seconds, I would run and take a quick little bathroom break. I would take a sip of Sprite, and then I would run back to the couch and then start tripping again. And the hallucinations. We had a bug problem, and I saw this giant spider on my bathroom door while I was in the bathroom. And I was like, I remember like going back to the bathroom and it was gone. To this day, I still have no idea if it was real or not. As I'm on the couch, I realize that the effects of the high are starting to actually calm down, and each trip isn't hitting me as hard as the last. Then all of a sudden, we hear the police bang on the door. Like, oh my God, we're going to jail. We both look at the door. We breathe. I'm ready. I'm ready to go to jail. Open the door. It's literally just the upstairs neighbor. And this hoe was on Adderall, tweaking out. Everybody on drugs. Everyone in the house on drugs. I thought this was a safe neighborhood. A neighbor takes Rumi into his room where he harasses him by turning the light switch on and off to make his trip even worse. My high at this point has calmed down. It feels really like I'm just drunk more than high. I'm just like, I look at the kitchen. It's exactly as we left it 5 hours ago when the high started. My chicken nugget is still half eaten, dipped in the sauce just as I left it, and that's it. I go to bed. This was terrible, and I'm never gonna do anything like this ever again. And I try to do it again like 2 months later.